matter what you're facing today, it's always a good time for hope and encouragement. So welcome to Keep the Faith. I'm Keith Stevens.
And I'm Donna Cruz. A new kind of world may cause you to have a new way of thinking, dreaming, and acting. And that can be good. On Keep the Faith today, you'll hear songs and stories to help you take your next steps encouraged.
Two-thirds of adults believe that there's one best fit job out there for them. Well, that's a lot of pressure if you are trying to find, you know, just this one best fit job. And really what we see through the research and through my own experience, callings change as we go through life. You know, life is a journey and God is taking us on that journey. And it's not going to be just this stagnant thing. Just as life unfolds, so too does your calling.
If there's a road I should walk, help me find it.
He just made a decision that, you know what, he said, I am not going to stay stuck here. And so he started moving forward. He went back to school, got his college degree, and lo and behold, he got a new passion, and he wanted to go into the medical field, and he wanted to become a nurse. And so he's living that dream today.
Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay.
What I discovered is that I was trying to manufacture transformation that only God can provide. I was going to will myself to be skinny. I was going to will myself to have a nice car and will myself to get an amazing job.
The lies I believed, they got some roots that run deep. I let them take a hold of my life. I let them take control of my life.
The very thing that I thought was going to kill me was actually the very thing that transformed me. And it was almost as if God took those trials to get my attention. And in those moments where we feel like we're forlorn and forgotten, when we feel like, God, where are you? Do you hear me? Do you see me? Do you care? That we could actually experience the very presence of God.
Look at me.
Maybe you love coffee. Well, now you have a chance to be coffee. Well, sorta. The story's next on Keep the Faith.
This world can be cold and bitter. It feels like we're in the dead of winter, waiting on something better. But am I really gonna hide forever? Let it
let go and trust the outcome to somebody stronger than you are, you find the kind of strength you truly need. On Keep the Faith, we call it contagious encouragement.
I remember how you told me that life may not be easy, and everything that I need, you've already given me. I remember how you told me I can trust you completely. So why am I doubting when you prove that you'd fight for me? You've walked me through fire, changed by your mercy, covered by your peace. I'm living out the victory. Doesn't mean I won't feel the heat. You've walked me through fire. My redemption, Lord, how could I question when you prove that you'd die for me? You've walked me through fire.
Listening to Keep the Faith. Hi, I'm Donna Cruz. When you look around at the world, you see change from conflicts to loss to new ways of doing things. And you can let the situations change you, or you can do your best to bring change to the situations. That sort of change is exactly what John Gordon writes about. He's a best-selling author with books like The Energy Bus, and he's co-written The Coffee Bean, a simple lesson to create positive change.
When you put a carrot into boiling hot water, what happens to the carrot? It gets weakened. It gets softened by its environment. When you put an egg into boiling hot water, what happens to the egg? It gets hardened by its environment. It gets... In our hearts, we get bitter, we get angry, we get jealous, right? We get hateful. But when you put a coffee bean into boiling hot water, the coffee bean is not impacted by its environment. Instead, it impacts its environment. It transforms that water into coffee. We don't even call it water anymore. We call it coffee. And biblically, Jesus said the kingdom of God is inside you. And so he was telling us that the power is inside of us, that we are in this world, but we are not of this world, that there is a greater power, his power, that lies within us. Like, hey, let's stop looking at the negativity. Let's stop looking at all these negative forces. Let's look inside and see that we have the power to change the world. We have the power to impact, to bring heaven to earth. So it never looks great, good. It never looks great. The circumstances often do not look good. And that's where faith comes in. That's where trust comes in. And that's where our ability to make a difference comes in.
In this obsession with the things this world says make us happy, can't see the slaves we are in all the searching, all the grasping. Like we deserve much more than all these blessings we're holding. So now I'm running free into an ocean of mercy, unending. Was chasing after, throw off these heavy chains that I have let become my master.
This is Keep the Faith.
Sometimes your new purpose is an invention of your circumstances. Well, coming up next on Keep the Faith, the story of countless young people who are glad that's the case.
I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemy. I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah.
New beginnings often start with one small choice. As you listen to Keep the Faith, we hope you find the strength to take step one.
Said I woke up to the summer, shining throat. Calling out my friends, asking what's the move. Feeling a little different, I'm on something new.
Today,
I ain't gonna let no clouds get in my way. The only road I'm walking is the one I pick. Catch me sitting in the sun, no time for shade.
Today,
this is the day that the Lord has made.
Ooh.
And I ain't gonna let it slip away. I'm gonna be
joyful.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I'm gonna be
joyful.
Today, I'm gonna be joyful. Ooh, I'm gonna be
joyful.
I got that feeling that you get when you get new kicks. Bell ringing on the last day of singing, yeah. High fiving everybody, but we out of here.
Today.
So fast, life comes and goes. Make it last, best slow your road. They don't take it as a choice, but you gotta know that
today's
the day.
Ooh.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Ooh.
And I ain't gonna let it slip away, nah.
I'm gonna be joyful.
I got the joy down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I got the J-O-Y down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I got the joy down in my heart, today. Mm.
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
I'm Brandy Lene. New routes sometimes have the best scenery. And it's true with your purpose, too. In her book, Ready to Rise, Jo Saxton shares how the unexpected can lead to beautiful things.
Seasons sometimes throw themselves upon us in ways we didn't expect. One of the people who I find the most magnificent example of this is a woman who actually fostered me. And she never intended to get into foster care. It began, actually, at the end of World War II, because in England, when children were being evacuated, when there were lots of bombing in London, so they were trying to keep kids safe, they sent them out of London into other parts of the country, and she started looking after children. She was single, she had room, she had space, she'd been supporting the war effort in other practical ways, and she fell in love with this idea of giving people this children this place of safety for a short period of time. And so she hadn't always planned that would be her journey. It uncovered out of tragedy, out of other people's tragedy, out of an intense time in the history of a country, that's where her purpose was uncovered. And basically, when the war effort stopped and there was peace, she continued to look for places and family situations where there wasn't peace and help them out. And I think for many women, we stumble upon our purpose. We stumble on it because circumstances require it, because tragedy or opportunity opens up to us. And it may be for 5 years, it may be for 50, but just because it's a short period of time doesn't mean it's not worthwhile. And I would encourage us to dare to do things for a season.
Sometimes sorrow is the door to peace. Sometimes heartache is the gift I need. You're faithful, faithful in all things. A holy thing.
shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. The Lord is my shepherd, leads me to still waters, and he restores my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Oh, the Lord is my shepherd, leads me to still waters.
Research shows us that 90% of the conflicts that we have in any relationship totally dissipate if that's all we do is accurately see that issue from the other person's perspective. And that's all part of this whole idea of self-giving love, of being able to transcend your own boundaries and recognize other people's needs that probably are different than your own.
Your love is greater.
This is Keep the Faith.
Next on Keep the Faith, Ryan Stevenson was working as a paramedic with a dream of pursuing music, but without the means to do so. Then a miracle happened.
Here is this 40-year-old lady who was unconscious, unresponsive, pulseless, you know, not breathing, totally dead. I just told everybody, I was like, stop what you're doing.
Count to three and say a prayer. Down for love and up for air. Underwater, overjoyed. Water for a thirsty soul. Water for a thirsty soul. Baptize me into your love. Oh, my spirit's overcome. Body, mind, and skin and bone. Love, I'm gonna make it known. Love, I'm gonna make it known.
Yeah, I'm coming alive with you. I'm coming alive with you. I was living a lie till you. I'm coming alive with you.
All the people say,
overwhelmed by you, and if the world is listening.
Welcome to a place where you can take in the gift of encouragement, a place where it becomes contagious. This is Keep the Faith.
Some people think you're distant, just some words on a page, that you're nothing more than fables handed down along the way. But I've seen you part the waters where no one else could pull me from the deep. That's who you are to me.
Some people think you just live in cathedrals made of stone, but I know you live inside my heart. I know that it's your home. And I've seen you in a sunset and in the eyes of a stranger on the street. That's who you are to me.
You're amazing, faithful, love's open door. When I'm empty, you fill me with hunger for more of your mercy, your goodness. Lord, you're the air that I breathe. That's who you are to me. Who you are to me.
Sometimes I have my doubts, I'm sure that everybody does. And I wonder when I stumble, am I still worthy of your love?
That I get stronger when I'm talking to you down on my knees.
You're everything I need. You're amazing, faithful, love's open door. When I'm empty, you fill me with hunger for more of your mercy, your goodness. Lord, you're
listening to Keep the Faith.
Hey, I'm Keith Stevens. You never know what or who will come along to help reinvent your life.
In the eye of the storm, you remain in control.
Ryan Stevenson is living out his musical dreams now, but there was a time when that seemed unrealistic. He was working as a paramedic and couldn't afford to put together a quality demo.
And I was on shift one day, and this 911 call got dispatched, and it came out as a lightning strike. Here is this 40-year-old lady who was unconscious, unresponsive, pulseless, you know, not breathing, totally dead. By the time we got there, we were way past our 10-minute window of actually being effective in any kind of resuscitation or any intervention, really. But I just felt like, man, we can't leave her. So we put her in the ambulance, started driving code 3 to the hospital. After about 3 or 4 minutes, I just looked over on my heart monitor and I just told everybody, I was like, stop what you're doing. Her heart came back, so we full on revived her in the back of the ambulance. Total miracle. After she wakes up out of a coma and goes through all this rehab, her and I met up at a breakfast that the county put on. And the more that she got to know me, She's just like, Ryan, there's just so much more to you than being a paramedic. And if you could do anything else, what would you do? And so I told her, I was like, well, my dream really is to do music full time and help people through my songs and connect with them that way. And she's like, well, what does that take? And I was like, at this point, it just literally takes money. And she wrote me a check that day. I feel like when the Lord has something special, he will really take his time preparing you and really building that story and building that journey, because he doesn't want it to be a flash in the pan. And when it's time, you don't have to ask heaven to open up any door. He just opens them up and you walk through them. He orchestrates your circumstances perfectly.
When the solid ground is falling out from underneath my feet, between the black skies and my red eyes, I can barely see. And when I'm feeling like I've been let down by my friends and my family, I can hear the rain reminding me. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds me. In the eye of the storm.
When my hopes and dreams are far from me and I'm running out of faith, I see the future I picture slowly fade away. And when the tears of pain and heartache are pouring down my face, I find my peace in Jesus' name. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control.
Yes, you do, Lord.
In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds.
And I just don't know how I'm gonna make ends meet. I did my best, now I'm scared to death that we might lose everything. And when a sickness takes my child away and there's nothing I can do, my only hope is to trust you. I trust you, Lord.
In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds me. In the eye of the storm.
Well, I look at a lot of people and they're so proud of themselves. And I just told a guy not long ago, I said, look, you won the genetic lottery. Everyone's not that lucky. There's a fine line in the longitude and latitude of the haves and the have-nots. There's just a fine line between the guy driving the really nice car and wearing the nice suit and the man holding the sign at the corner and says, I'll work for food. So next time you see that person and you are driving the nice car and have the nice suit on, turn around.
Give me your eyes for just 1 second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
This is Keep the Faith.
I'm Rodriguez on Keep the Faith and hear some contagious encouragement from Mr. Rogers. Often, when you think you're at the end of something, you're at the beginning of something else.
I've never known a love like yours. So intimate, so powerful. And I've tasted, I've seen, and nothing comes close. I've never known a love like yours. Jesus, your name is power. It's breath and living water. And your spirit guides me to the heart of the Father. Let your praise ring louder every day and every hour. 'Cause your spirit guides me to the heart of the Father. I've never felt at home like this. Just like a child, so innocent. And I'm safe inside your arms, 'cause you won't let go. I've never known a love like yours, no. Jesus, your name is power. It's breath and living water. And your spirit guides me to the heart.
Contagious encouragement on Keep the Faith.
Hey, I'm Stephen Curtis Chapman. You know, there's a purpose for the journey you're on in life. And maybe it's to encourage someone else who's going through the same things. Someone who's listening right now. Please call 800-726-4150. That's 800-726-4150.
My husband husband and I tried for six and a half years to get pregnant, and the doctors couldn't figure out what was wrong with me. Finally, I just gave up and said, I'm done. I can't do anything more. To that point, I thought that considering adoption would be giving up on that. I just knew that it wasn't until he finally brought me to a place of brokenness where I was able to cry out to him and say, God, I want the child that you want me to have, not the child that I am willing to have. My husband actually was brought to a place where God put him in the right place at the right time, and he met a lady at his place of work who was crying to a coworker because her granddaughter was pregnant. And so my wonderful big mom's husband walked up and said, you don't know who I am, but I want to tell you that this baby would be loved if you could convince your granddaughter to consider adoption. And then he walked away. And that woman researched and found out who he was, and she talked to her daughter and her granddaughter, and they, and 2 weeks later, she came back to my husband and she said, my daughter and my granddaughter want to talk to you and your wife about adopting this baby.
There is no fear, 'cause I believe. There is no doubt, 'cause I have seen your faithfulness. My fortress, over and over. I have a hope found in your name. I have a strength found in your grace. Your faithfulness, my fortress, over and over.
Make way through the world. God, I believe in you. Release your love inside of me. Unleash your power for all to see. Spirit, come and fall on us. Over and over.
All things are possible in you.
God of exceedingly, God of abundantly, more than we ask or think. Lord, you will never fail. Your name is powerful. Your words unstoppable. All things are possible in you.
Make way through the over and over.